here's Taves, centering one, score! And Oduya left point, a long drive, tap, score! Dave Bolin puts it in!
2 goals in 17 seconds!
As time expires, and the Chicago Blackhawks are Stanley Cup champions in 2013.
Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final in Boston, the Chicago Blackhawks. It looked like you guys had the game in hand to force a Game 7. It didn't go that way. Final seconds of the game, everything changed. How long did that take to get over? Does it serve as added motivation going into this season?
It definitely serves as motivation, but you know what? I don't think we've still overcome that, what happened. I don't think you ever will. I mean, it's there. You just have to live with it and deal with it. But the funny thing is that we did the same thing to Toronto in the first round, and then we got same treatment from Chicago. So, it happened. Happens in hockey. Things turn around quickly. And our thing was, we left it all out there, and we had no regrets about our game and that we could have done something differently. It's just, bounce here and bounce there, and all of a sudden you lose a game. So it's there, in your mind, and you live with it, and you move on, and you try to win it the next year.
There were so many critics wondering whether you could get the team to the Stanley Cup Final, and you did just that, and whether you could be the number one Bruin goaltender, and you have proved just that. Do you feel like you've finally silenced those critics who, along the way, have maybe questioned you as a goaltender?
Maybe, to a certain point. I don't think you can ever silence everybody. There are always going to be some people who criticize you about something, and it's part of the game, it's part of life. But at least I proved myself that I'm capable of playing in a high level of hockey for many, many games. But to silence the critics, I don't think it's possible.
There will be some new faces in the locker room and a lot of your former teammates who left in the offseason and via trade. But Jerome Iginla is one of those faces who's going to join the Boston Bruins. What is it like to add a player like Jerome Iginla on your team?
He's a great guy. You hear so many stories about him, what kind of guy he is and what he brings to the team, and it's just good to see that it was all true, that he's a really, really character guy on ice and off the ice, and the way he carries himself. So he's going to be a great add for us.
This offseason you signed a big contract to remain a Boston Bruin for quite some time. How important was it for you to get that deal done and to remain a part of this particular organization?
Yeah, it was something I wanted to do the day that I started being a Bruin. I loved every second of being in Boston and being with the Bruins. So it was a big thing, and I hope I can just stay with the team the next 8 years and hopefully more after that, because I think we've done, as an organization, that the management and staff has done a great job of building a competitive teams in these last 4 or 5 years, and hopefully that keeps going and I can be a part of that.
Do you feel that there's a little added pressure when you sign a big contract like that?
Yeah, well, as a goalie, you always have pressure on, but then again, people are starting looking at the money you make and stuff like that. So it just brings another aspect to that, but for me, it doesn't matter. I just want to be good every day.